These days, Michael Garreau gets a kick out of doing work around the yard. He and his wife, Marie, are a young, outdoorsy couple just starting their family with baby boy Tobias. Hiking and mountain climbing are what they love to do. But one night, Michael went to sleep, and by the next morning, their lives were changed.
About 2 years ago, I woke up one morning and I was going paralyzed. I tried to get out of my chair and I couldn't get out of my chair.
A bout with bronchitis turned into something else. It came like a thief in the night, stealing his ability to walk. First, his legs felt weak, and within hours, he was in the hospital, paralyzed from head to toe.
Within 3 days, I was on a ventilator. Couldn't breathe. Completely immobile.
He could think, he could feel pain, but the only thing he could move were his eyes. Michael had Guillain-Barré syndrome, a rare disorder that happens when the body's immune system suddenly attacks the nervous system. It's usually triggered by an illness or infection and ultimately leads to paralysis. In Michael's case, it almost took his life.
As the disease was progressing and getting worse and worse, and the idea of death, the possibility of this being terminal coming up, I never freaked out. It was almost like I couldn't really dwell on that, and some people call that denial, but I believe it was the sovereign hand of God just over my eyes, just saying, trust me. And he gives us grace for the here and now, but he doesn't give grace for the hypothetical.
Michael and Marie say they trusted in God in the face of something they could not understand. It was a test of their faith.
One of the biggest struggles for me was, in regards to Tobias, is how could God keep me from being a father to Tobias, from being loving him and being there with him when he was 4 months old when I went into the hospital. And those were questions that I really struggled with.
The very thing he struggled with is one of the things that motivates him to keep pushing towards recovery 2 years later. There's no guarantee he'll ever get back to where he used to be, but he's come a long way. His motor skills have started to return, and though every step is a struggle, his wife Marie, who by the way is now pregnant with twins, is by his side.
You know that God is good, and then when something like this happens, sometimes it's like, wow, how could a good God cause something like this to happen? And it causes you to question and really search the scriptures, and in that way it tests your faith.
But unlike Nineveh, who responds, right?
And faith is something Michael teaches his students about these days in class.
Think of to myself, well, I can't use my hands, I can't use my legs, so I can use my head, you know, so I can teach, and that's where God's put me, is to teach.
Michael teaches courses at a Bible college in the upstate from his own life's journey.
I was telling my students just today, there's nothing that pleases God more than faith that's genuine faith that's true. And the only way you can test if faith is true is by going through trials like this.
Much like this bush, their lives have been shaped and pruned to grow deeper in their beliefs.
Yeah, God always